Hey there, it's Alan with Brentwood's Polychem Solutions team. In this episode, I'd like to focus on shear pins. The shear pin is notorious among mechanics and operators since it's the component that makes them go out in the rain, snow, or dark of night to fix. However, a broken shear pin deserves more critical insight than it typically receives. Trying to fix the issue by simply replacing that pin with a B7 bolt or other high-strength substitute puts your collector at risk of catastrophic failure. A shear pin's purpose is to protect the drive assembly. Causes of shear pin failure can be abrupt or chronic. Abrupt cases, like foreign objects in the tank, are often obvious and don't require much investigation. These instances leave a telltale mark on the pin. Notice how this pin's surface has a clear smear from overload failure. More challenging failures cause the shear pin to break via fatigue. These are small events that create tension pulses in the system, gradually putting cyclic stresses on the shear pin until it breaks. In this example, the fatigue pin surface is not a nice uniform shear, but has a rough surface complete with beach marks. Fortunately, the pin has done its job to avoid larger failures, but we need to do our job to understand the root cause. Ripples on the water's surface also indicate a small snag somewhere. This stresses the pin, which over time will result in fatigue failure. The magnitude of the snag will determine time between failures. While there's no substitute for a full tank inspection to determine the root cause of frequent pin failures, here are some tips for identifying common causes. Number one, high hardware. Check for bolts that protrude from the wear strip. Look for bright, shiny screw heads, especially if there are any peened over. This breaks pins over time if not corrected. Even if properly installed, foreign material can jam into the hardware's cavity and loosen it, creating a snag. Uneven wear strip or strip responding to floor variations can also cause localized heavy loading. Number two, evenly spaced wear strip. Best practice for wear strip installation is to have it out of phase so that the wear shoes do not both hit a gap at the same time. This can be a larger problem if the entire series of flights hit. Watching flights on the surface can be a telltale sign. Another common issue is broken strip and the ends getting damaged. Using wear shoes cut from a 90-degree angle may have a sharp leading edge that can make the situation worse. Number three, misalignment. Chain that isn't properly centered on the sprocket or misalignment among the drive chain can cause pulses and tension. In serious cases, this will create surface ripples. Check alignment and ensure that there is no chain belly under the 40-tooth bull gear. Number four, offset chain misalignment. Chain that slips or skips a sprocket tooth can contribute to fatigue failures. There are two ways to see if a chain has skipped. One is to visually line up a flight with a known straight line, like a tank wall. Notice in this clip how the flight is not parallel to the concrete, although we've all seen some substandard concrete work before. Another method is to watch the flight as it submerges. Chain difference will result in one side of the flight submerging sooner than the other. If the flight does not turn around the rear idler smoothly, depending on the severity of the skip, it can make contact with the rear wall. This requires further attention. Number five, worn pin cavity. After a few changes, it isn't uncommon for the bore of the pin to deform. Deformation allows the pin to move, contributing to fatigue failure. If a pin was ever stuck and had to be forcibly removed, this is likely part of the overall problem. Number six, floor or wall contact. If the tank has bulged, floated or moved, the flight can contact it and create pulses from drag. This also happens if the wear strip gets too thin or if the T-rail corrodes and snags the flight. These causes can range in severity, so it's recommended to change shear pins annually, even without a brake, to ensure that the pin has full brake strength and isn't stuck or corroded into the hub. Most importantly, it can be scheduled during regular work hours. Remember, a shear pin is like a circuit breaker. When it breaks, it is letting you know that there's an issue that requires attention. Frequent breaks can be frustrating to diagnose. For questions on shear pins or assistance on diagnosing failures, please reach out to us at brentwoodindustries.com/polychem.